Good morning, good morning. What a blessing it is for us to come together one more time. Wherever we may be, whether we be far or whether we be near, but God is everywhere. We should be giving God some praises this morning for all of his many, many blessings. Oh, what a mighty God we serve. Praise him in the morning, praise him in the noonday, praise him in the evening time. Praise him at night. It's praise time. It's praise time. Let's give God some praise on his day. These and all we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Good morning, St. Stephen's. This morning's scripture read is coming from 1 John chapter 5, verses 13 through 15. And the scripture reads, "These things I have written to you who believe in the name of the Son of God, that you may know that you have eternal life, and that you may continue to believe in the name of the Son of God. Now, this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. And if we believe that he hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have the petition that we have asked of him. May the Lord add a blessing to the reader and hear of his blessed word. Amen."
Our Father, we pause at this time just to say thank you. Thank you, Father, and praying that you will ever keep us in the zone of usefulness, in the way of righteousness, that you will enable us, our Father, to be mindful of you in all our endeavors and whatever we do. We pray, Father, that you bless us and keep us and guide us through the rest of this day. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Bless the Lord, everybody. Good morning. These are your announcements for today as we stay connected in crisis. Ministry work in preparation at St. Stephen's continues to go on. On Monday, these are our meetings at 6:30 p.m. The phone number is 302-202-1108. These meetings are not on Zoom. For the Brotherhood, when you dial in, the access code is 465-742. Our youth and pastors meeting, the access code is 118-056. Now, for Christian women, please note there will not be a meeting on Monday. Okay. We continue to expect Christian growth this week. On Tuesday on Zoom at 6:30 p.m., there'll be the study, Faith Works, Fasting to Break Failure and Defeat with Pastor Biggs. On Wednesday on Zoom at 10:30 a.m. is the Bible Power Hour, Zechariah chapters 13 and 14 with Deacon Patterson. At 6 o'clock p.m. on Wednesday is the chat with the pastor, open conversations and fellowship. And then 6:30 p.m. on Wednesday is the prayer call, where the full focus will be on prayer only. Our Lord's Worship Day on Sunday at 10 o'clock a.m. is the Sunday School SSBC Zoom with Deacons Griffin and Burton. 11 o'clock p.m. a.m. is our worship, SSBC on YouTube. Then at 12 noon is prayer and the Lord's Supper on SSBC Zoom with Pastor Biggs. Our YouTube connection is YouTube.com/user/Reverend Biggs. And then Zoom is https://zoom.us/j635047066. The meeting ID is 635-047-066. Do you need a job? Workintexas.com. There are businesses that have open positions in San Antonio. These include 7-Eleven, Amazon, C6 Services, Christus Health, Combined Insurance, Dollar General, Dollar Tree, HEB, John Wayne Service Company, Rackspace, Methodist Healthcare, the San Antonio State Hospital, Walmart, and Whataburger. These are places that are hiring. Christian Women Prayer Call. Attention all members, especially the sick and all of us that are shut in. The Christian Women's Ministry wants to pray with and for you on Thursday, April the 30th at 6:30 p.m. We want you to dial in at 302-202-1108, and the conference code is 222-344. This will be on Thursday, April the 30th at 6:30 p.m. We want all of you to pick up your family's communion servings. Our deacons will be standing by to hand out communion elements on Saturday, May the 2nd at 10, from 10 o'clock a.m. to 12 o'clock noon. This will be touchless serving. And these are your announcements.
Good morning, St. Stephen's family and friends. We welcome you to our online virtual service. We are immensely grateful that you have tuned in on this morning. Although we are not physically together, we are still spiritually connected, and we'll go forth into worshiping and praising God within our home. From the Bryant and Falls family, we send our love and pray for your safety and well-being. Thanks for your commitment, courage, and compassion. God bless you, and we will see you soon.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
come this far by faith, leaning on everlasting God. If we ever needed to pray, we sure do need to pray right now. For God said, bring all his children together, assemble them together, and call upon his name. For what a friend, oh, what a friend we have in Jesus. All of our sins and our griefs to bear. He said, bring all your burdens to me and just leave them there. And I will take care of them. Father God, as we come before you this morning, Father God, we come in with heads bowed, hearts in prayer, coming for no other form but to lift up the name of Jesus. But Father God, you're worthy of all of our praises. For it was you and you alone that watched over us all night long, woke us up this morning with a portion of health and strength, and we just stopped by to say thank you. Thank you for your amazing grace. For it was grace that have brought us safety for, and it was grace that will lead us on. Father God, we come looking down upon your children this morning. Father God, wherever they may be, Father God, we just ask that you just put your arms of protection around them. Lord God, protect them from all harm and danger. For we know that all power in heaven and earth is in your hand. Father God, you made us and you know all about us, from the top of our head to the sole of our feet. Lord God, we come this morning just asking for mercy. Mercy, Father God, for all the things that's going on in the world today. But Father God, we know that you're still in control, and ain't nothing too big for our God. Father God, as we come this morning, Father God, we come with hard hearts this morning. Father God, we just open and ask that you open up a heart this morning. Open up a mind this morning, Father God, that may be troubled. Father God, for we know that you have the answers. And Father God, we just stop dying just to say thank you. Thank you for all that you've done. Thank you for all that you're doing. And Father God, if we're going to continue on this road, Father God, it be by your grace and by your mercy. For Father God, we're not worried about the virus, because Lord, we know that you have it in the palm of your hand. And we just know one word from the master this morning will make everything all right. And Father God, we just ask that you look down upon our sick and shut in. Father God, touch them as only you can. Father God, because we know one touch from the master's hand will make everything all right. And Father God, we just ask that you just draw us all together in one band of Christian love. Blessed if it be thy holy will. And Father God, though we may be far, we may be near, but we know that you are everywhere. And Father God, you just said, just call upon me. Call upon me, Father. For you said, if I be lifted up from the earth, that you draw all men unto you. Father God, we just ask that you forgive us of all our sins, whether they're sins of omission, sins of commission. For you said in your word that we all have sinned and come short of your glory. Father God, we just ask for forgiveness right now. And Father God, we just ask that you just take us and mold us. Mold us into be what you have us to be. Father God, that we can lift up holy hands and give you praises and give you glory. For you're worthy of all of our praise. And Father God, we just ask that you look down upon our pastor and his family. Father God, continue to strengthen, continue to guide him, Father God, that he may be able to guide the flock that you have put him in charge of. Father God, build him up on every weak side. Father God, build him up where he toned down. And Father God, as he prepare for a word from heaven, Father God, we just pray that it just pierce our hearts. Father God, that we can leave from this place and go tell a dying world that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. Father, we thank you for Jesus, for dying out on Calvary's hill, that we too might have a right to the tree of life. And Father God, we just ask that you just hold us together. Hold us together, Father God, so that once we're back assembling in your house, in your place, Father God, that we're giving you all the praise and all the worship. Father God, for you deserve it. You're worthy. You're worthy. You're worthy. For these and all blessings, we ask in Jesus' name. For Christ we pray and ask it all. Amen, amen, and amen.
And no, all Every acknowledgement belongs to our Lord and King. Blessings and glory, wisdom and power belongs to our Lord and King. All of the praises, every belongs to our Lord and King. Here is our praise. Here is our praise. Here is our praise. Here is our praise. Here is our praise.
By sharing with us in this worship experience, all of the workers, y'all see the work that is going on behind the scenes. We are doing ministry right here in the St. Stephen's family. Oh God, here is our praise. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you today for your grace and your mercy. Thank you for your truth, Lord. Undergird us, Lord, with your word now, Father. Let us stand on your word, God, and let us stand on your promises. Give your people strength now, God. Bless your word as only you can. We thank you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Our scripture today is found in Ephesians chapter 6. Ephesians chapter 6. Verse 13 says, therefore, take up the whole armor of God, New King James Version, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Stand, therefore, having girded your waist with truth, having put on the breastplate of righteousness, and having shod your feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, with which you will be able to quench the fiery darts of the wicked one, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Hallelujah. We want to speak this morning from the thought, God dressed and equipped us well. Y'all need to hear me. God dressed and equipped us well. If you ever needed a reminder and a reassurance that we have what we need, amen, in a time of crisis, today is a day that we need to be reminded that God has already equipped us well. As believers in Christ Jesus, we don't have to worry about external resources. We just need to rejoice in the reality that we have all of the internal resources that we need. I'm speaking spiritual and carnal, y'all. We don't have to worry about the things of this world because we have all the God we need. This text is an awesome text. People are trying to get this and that stock up, but we already have what we need. And I just want to take an exegetical approach to this text today. I just want to unpack these few reminders of what God has already given us. And he told us how to dress in it through Paul's letter. He told us how to get ourselves ready for battle. Amen. And how to get up in the morning. Battle starts. You got to take off your clothes and shower and clean up spiritually. Well, that's all right. Get dressed again. Get dressed today. Get dressed tomorrow. Get dressed the next day. Every day that God gives you, get dressed. Put on the whole armor of God. God has indeed dressed us well. He has equipped us well. He has given us all that we need, amen, to face what we face today. He says, gird your loins with truth. Gird your loins with truth. Put on in that reproductive area. Replace, amen, that which you reproduce ought to be founded in truth. What is truth? What is truth? Exegetically, truth is that that is in accord with what really happens. Truth are facts that correspond with reality. Yeah. Eternal reality is not limited to historical fact. I needed to say that because you need to know the difference between facts that correspond with reality and reality based on facts. We don't have to worry about the facts of this world. We need to know that the facts of this world align up with the reality of God. And some things go beyond the minimal limited facts of this world. What comes to mind is the situation of Jesus walking on the water, and the believers are in the boat. And in Matthew 14:33, after Peter asks for permission to walk on water, and Jesus tells him to come, and then he takes his attention off of him temporarily, and he begins to sink, and Jesus grabs him by the hand and carries him back to the boat. And when they get to the land, in verse 33 of Matthew 14, I can hear the believers, all of those that were on the boat, saying, truly, you are the Son of God. I can see at the cross of Calvary, while everybody had all types of things to say about who Jesus is. Oh, when it was all said and done, I can see the centurion in Matthew 27 and 54 saying, truly, this was the Son of God. That's truth, my brothers and sisters. that extends beyond the limited facts of this world. That's truth that extends into the eternal realm. Because for Jesus to be the Son of God is to recognize that he's not limited to what's here. Before here is, I am. And after here is gone, I am. Yeah. Before the world was, Jesus is. After the world is, Jesus is. The Son of God is the Son of God. Thanks be to God. So gird your loins with truth and put on the breastplate of righteousness. What is righteousness? Righteousness is simply doing what is required by God. Don't get too complicated with righteousness. Keep it simple. Just do what is required by God. When you do that, you are indeed, my brothers and sisters, doing what's right. Romans chapter 1, verse 16 and 17 says, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God to salvation for everyone who believes, for the Jews first, and also for the Greek. For in it is the righteousness of God is revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by faith." We ought to live by, amen, having faith that God is God. And we do what's right because God is God. And we can hang our hat on that, my brothers and sisters. And we can put that over our heart. We can put that over our lungs. We can put that over our stomach. We can gird our breast with the things, amen, of righteousness before the Lord. I like the way the Message Bible says it. It puts it in common English. It says, "It's news I'm most proud to proclaim. This extraordinary message of God's powerful plan to rescue everyone who trusts him. Starting with the Jews and then right on to everyone else. God's way of putting people right shows up in the acts of faith, confirming what scripture has said all along. The person in right standing before God by trusting him really lives." The person in right standing before God by trusting him really lives. You don't know what life is until you learn to trust God. And when you trust God, God will reveal to you what real life is. That's good news. That's good news. That's the breastplate of righteousness, amen, that has followed the girding of our loins with the truth. Thirdly, put the feet, shod your feet, cover your feet with the gospel of peace. To shod is literally to tie on. So some things need to be strapped on to you. You need to, you know, some things you can put on, but some things need to be tied down so that they don't slip off. Tie your feet with the gospel so that you don't slip off of your solid foundation. Shod also implies that which is underneath. So you tie on that which you're going to be able to stand on. Because if anything slips, you don't want to slip off of that. Oh, which is tied on to you. We are to be ready at all times, my brothers and sisters, to carry the good news wherever we go. Because when it's tied onto your feet, no matter where your feet go, what's tied to them is with you. And if it is the gospel, that the gospel simply means the good news. And the good news ought to be carried to somebody. We're hearing enough bad news. We're hearing enough inaccurate news. We're hearing enough untruthful news. We're hearing enough ignorant news. I don't know about you, but I'm glad to know that there is good news. Yeah. And it says the gospel of peace, not just any gospel, but the gospel of peace. What is peace? Peace is tranquility, my brothers and sisters. Peace is freedom from worry. You don't have to worry because you have the peace of God. I know I'm right about it. Jesus said in John 14, 27, "Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. Yeah, the peace of God will surpass all understanding. It will make absolutely no sense to the unbeliever, but it makes all of the sense in the world to the man or the woman, the boy or the girl that has accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Hallelujah, somebody. We are dressed and equipped very well because of the God that's on our side. Amen. Not only do we have our feet shod with the gospel of peace, but we have the shield of faith. Come on, somebody. The shield of faith is simply believing with total trust. You're believing in what God has said, and you're trusting him totally at his word, that there is no room for doubt. Mark 11, 20 says, now in the morning as they passed by, they saw the fig tree dried up from the roots. And Peter, remembering, said, Rabbi, look, the fig tree which you cursed has withered away. So Jesus answered and said, have faith in God. Oh, Lord. For surely I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, be thou removed and be cast into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believe that those things he says will be done, he will have whatever he says. Jesus says, therefore, I say to you, whatever things you ask for when you pray, believe that you receive them and you will have them. Good God Almighty, if we would just believe and trust God totally, everything would be all right. He goes on to say, amen, amen, amen. The kind of faith that others can witness ought to be shown in our actions. God's people ought to express the kind of faith that others can relate to and want some of. Amen, amen, amen. Jesus wants us to give our all to him. God wants us to trust him totally and fully. And in order to do that, we ought to show some signs. It's more than what comes out of our mouth. It ought to come out of our hearts. It ought to come out of our actions. It ought to come out of our walk. It ought to come out of our talk. It ought to come out of our shout. It ought to come out of our praise. Amen. What God has put in you ought to come out of you. I can see Paul as he opens up in the letter to the church at Rome in verse 8. He says, I thank my God through Jesus Christ for you all, that your faith is spoken of throughout the whole world. Everybody is talking about how you are living what you believe, how you are trusting who you believe. God is God, God is God, God is God. And God's people ought to act like they believe that. God's people ought to show that. God's people ought to walk in it. God's people ought to live in it. God's people ought to love in it. God's people ought to lean in it. Because wherever you are covered by the blood of the Lamb. Whatever you're going through, you may even catch a sickness, and God forbid. But while you are in that sickness, I need to remind you that you're still covered by the blood. Amen. For it is given unto man one time to die. All of us are going to die. But after this, the judgment. And so no matter what the vehicle of death is, the bottom line is if you are trusting God totally, even when your body dies, you live. That there is a tomorrow, amen, for every believer. Thank God for tomorrow. The shield of faith, that which moves around and catches the darts, is a faith that must totally believe in God, totally trust in God, and totally lean on God. Put on the helmet of salvation. What am I covering my mind with? What am I covering my brain with? Oh man, I need to cover my mind and my brain with the knowledge that God saves. God is our Savior. God is our coverer. God is our keeper. God is our sustainer. We are covered by the blood of the Lamb. I see in Acts 28 and 8, Paul, after quoting Isaiah, amen, Isaiah's concern for God's people who were rejecting salvation because of their poor spiritual hearing and their poor spiritual vision. I see Paul saying, therefore, let it be known to you that the salvation of God has been sent to the Gentiles, and they will hear it. That's good news, my brothers and sisters. If the gospel goes out, if the word of God goes out, if the salvific power of God goes out, people will receive it. So those of us that are walking with it shod on our feet, if we would just share it, people will receive it and believe it. That is our helmet of salvation. Amen. Which is also the sword of the Spirit. Well, what is the sword of the Spirit? Oh, that rhema, that word of God, that sword of the Spirit is the word of God. That rhema, the God, the Godness in the word, and the word in the Godness. Word that is already spoken. A rhema word is not a brand new word. A rhema word is really a repeat word to remind you of what God has already said, what God has already shared, what God has already done is going to do it again. He's spoken it, and he's speaking it again. And it's a word that you can hear clearly, different from the logos. The rhema word is a word that you can hear. It's a timely word. It's a relevant word. It's a piercing word. It's a life-changing word. It's a game-changing word. It's a hope-having word. It's a love-keeping word. It's a lifting word. It's a power word. It's a promising word. And it's a present word. If you would just trust in our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ, a rhema word is coming your way. And you can put it on as part of what you already have. Because God says, in his word, that the Holy Spirit will bring all things into your remembrance. And you remember because he's already shared it with you. You remember because he's already put it in you. You remember because he's already revealed it to you. Yes, it's a rhema word coming your way. And a rhema word you can count on, because a rhema word has already been spoken by God. And a rhema word will be spoken again by God. And you can count on it. Yes, God has dressed and equipped us very well for this season and every season we face. You are all right, my brothers and my sisters. Don't you look down. Hold your head up. Don't you look back. Look forward to where the Lord is carrying you. Don't you look over. Keep your eye and your mind stayed on Jesus. The key is to believe. You got to keep on praying. You got to keep on leaning and depending on God. But when you do it in full belief. Now you can't believe, thank you, Holy Spirit, in whom you have not accepted. This is a good time for someone hearing my voice today to accept Jesus as personal Lord and Savior of your life. If you're local, we want you to come and show your place, your face in the place when we are able to gather again. Let us know that God has brought you into his army through the work of his church family called St. Stephen's Baptist Church at 2011 East Carson Street in San Antonio, Texas. And we want you to be a part of our growth ministry, of our working ministry, of our loving ministry. We want you to learn who God is alongside of us. We want you to learn how to live a holy life alongside of us. So you make sure you contact us by phone or by email, however you do it, but you contact us so that we can connect you. We don't have to wait to get together in the building to connect. We can connect right now. So if you're being spoken to this morning and you're making that decision about your life right now and you're local in the San Antonio community, we're glad to have you and we thank God for you. The Bible says when one is saved, all of heaven rejoices. Not only is all of heaven rejoicing over you, but all of God's children in his family called St. Stephen's is rejoicing with you. Likewise, if you're not in this area, if you're in another area, contact us. Let us help you connect with a local body wherever you are to help you to grow in the knowledge and the grace of God. There's a word for you. There's a place for you. There's security in the family for you. There's reassurance for you in the kingdom of God. Welcome, welcome to the kingdom of God. We thank all of you for sharing with us on today. Be reminded that God has dressed and equipped us well. We have on our garments, we have our shield, and we have our sword. We're able to do warfare at the highest level, and it's all because of Almighty God. Lord, we thank you today. Thank you for all that you've done. Thank you for all that you're doing. And thank you for all that you will do. Continue to bless your children, Heavenly Father, as only you can. Continue to bless your word. Let it continue to go out and penetrate hearts, reassuring the believer and drawing the unbeliever, God, that we all may be one in the body of Christ. Watch over and keep us now, as only you can. May your grace, your mercy, and your truth rest, rule, and abide with us now and forever. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. We love you, and we hope to see you very soon.